So students will be doing a quick revision of halo chapter, halo alkanes and halo arenes. So to start with, we will first do a preparation of halo alkanes and halo arenes. Okay. So first preparation, we will do it from alcohol. So I will not give all the steps, but from alcohol, what are the various ways we can get? So basically, I want to convert ROH to RCl. So this is my aim. How do I convert this? This can be done with the help of PCl5, PCl3, SOCl2. I can also do by HCl plus ZnCl2. If this is the method, this is called a Lucas reagent, and this Lucas reagent helps us to distinguish between primary, secondary and tertiary. How does it help to differentiate that tertiary? In Lucas reagent, tertiary alcohol reacts quickly compared to secondary, compared to primary. So this is how we can convert. So depending upon what reactant I am taking, so my byproduct will be, say for PCl5, it will be POCl3 and HCl. So basically, from alcohols, we can produce RCl with the help of these other reagents. So this is the first one. Second, if I ask from alkane, say for example, I take a alkane, say this, and I want to prepare CH3, CH2, Cl. So what do I do is, I do, if you all remember, we add chlorine in presence of sunlight. Okay, this is very important. This is this substitution reaction, again very important to remember, it is exclusively for saturated hydrocarbon. It's for saturated hydrocarbon. When I say that, I would like to specify here, if I am writing CH3 and I am writing Cl2 with H mu, very important. You should remember that the Cl will not go to ortho para, in fact it will go to the saturated hydrocarbon. So what is important to remember, that wherever you see a Cl2 with H mu, you have to remember that this reaction is specifically for your saturated hydrocarbon. Am I clear? So next we will go for the Sandnius reaction. Again, a very very important reaction. We will be also, we have studied in when we were doing amines, a very very important reaction. Amine, we start from aniline, right? Aniline, when first reacts with NaNO2 plus HCl, please remember, sometimes you will also see only they have given HNO2, nitrous acid. So you have to understand, the nitrous acid is same as NaNO2 plus HCl, because NaNO2 plus HCl reacts with HNO2 to give a diazonium chloride. It gives a diazonium chloride, and this diazonium chloride can be used for converting various different types of aromatic hydrocarbons. So for example, if I want to prepare a if I want to prepare a chlorobenzene, we use Cu2Cl2HCl. Similarly, if I want to prepare a bromobenzene, right, a bromobenzene, then I can use a Cu2Br plus HBr. Similarly, when I prepare CuCn, so I can add CuCn to get a CN. Similarly, very important, if I want fluorine, then I add HBF4. So these are the few things which you have to remember for the preparation of aryl halide, okay, halo alkenes, right? So if we go to the next preparation, in diazonium, we can also convert it to directly to benzene also. So if you remember, to convert it directly to benzene, when we react a diazonium chloride, to C2H5OH, then we also get a benzene. Okay, so these are the steps. Then we will find out from alkene. Very important. Again, it is a Markovnikov's rule. Markovnikov's rule says that the negative part of the addendum, that is when we react it with HBr, the negative part of the addendum goes to the carbon atom containing lesser number of hydrogen atom across the double bond. Means the Br, the negative part of the addendum, will go to the carbon atom containing lesser number of hydrogen atom. So we will get CHBrCH3. Very important reaction when we need a change of positions. I have explained before also. So if I add HBr with H2O2, then we get an anti. This is a Markovnikov's rule and this is a anti-Markovnikov's rule. So this is a Markovnikov's Markovnikov's rule and this is anti-Markovnikov rule. So here we get it is just the opposite of it. Okay, yeah. So this is what about the preparation. Then if I have to convert, say for example, I take a toluene and I want to chlorinate it. Chlorination of any aromatic hydrocarbon, so we can do it. And Cl2 in presence of Fe, dark. Okay, so we can get an ortho and para position. So basically, if I want to introduce a halogen in an ortho and para position, or a halogen, if I want to introduce a halogen, an aromatic compound, yes, I can do with the help of chlorination in Fe dark. So this is all about the preparation of haloalkenes. Okay students, we shall continue with the preparation halogen exchange. So there are two reactions, naming reaction specifically. It is Filkenstein's reaction and Stewart's reactions. Now it is little difficult to produce if I want to make a halide of iodide. So it is difficult to introduce iodine and similarly fluorines. Okay, so suppose I want to make methyl fluoride, the preparation which I said before is not very comfortable. So what we do is we do halogen exchange. Say suppose I want to introduce I here, so I can take any halogen. Say I can take RCl and react with NaI. So I get NaCl and Ri. So basically I want an Ri which has to be done in presence of dry acetone, which is a Filkenstein's reaction. So it is named as a Filkenstein's reaction. Similarly, if I want to introduce a fluoride group, so these are the few reagents. I have specified all of them for the simple reason because when they give either AgF, Ag2F2, cobalt difluoride or antimony trifluoride, so you should not be confused that all these are fluorinating agent. They help to introduce a fluoride and this method is called a Swartz reaction. So I thought let us just revise some reactions related to the preparation, which is very important. Now you see again, this is the Markovnikov's rule, which says the negative part of the addendum goes to the carbon atom across the double bond. So these are the two carbon atom across the double bond. It will go to the one which contains lesser hydrogen. So if I analyze this carbon, it has got 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so it has got, now if I see this, this has got 1, 2, 3 and there is a hydrogen. So who is having lesser hydrogen? This carbon. So my answer in that case will be this, this double bond will go, okay, I'll rewrite it once again. Yes, so my answer will be here, this will come CH3 here and I here and the CH will be there. So is that clear? What I'm trying to specify here is the negative part of the addendum goes to the carbon atom containing lesser number of hydrogen atom अक्रॉस द डबल बॉन्ड, जहां पे दो डबल बॉन्ड है उसमें से उस कार्बन के पास जाता है जिसके पास कम हाइड्रोजन है. सिमिलरली नाउ अगेन दिस इज अ रिएक्शन विच इज स्पेसिफिकली फॉर सैचुरेटेड. तो किधर है, वी कैन नॉट इंट्रोड्यूस हियर, दिस आर नॉट सैचुरेटेड. विच इज सैचुरेटेड, दिस इज सैचुरेटेड. सो वेरी सिंपल, इट विल बी एनओ टू हियर एंड सैचुरेटेड, सो सी एच टू सी एच टू बी आर. ओके, सो इट गोज हियर. Now here, this is a very simple, this is again, we can just see when I put an NaI, that means I am doing a Filkenstein's reaction. So I get a CH2CH2I plus NaBr. Now here, very important, again, it is only for whom? Saturated. It will only go and add in saturated. This is saturated? No, there it is, double bond. So it will go anywhere other than across this two double bond. This is what you have to remember. Whenever you see H mu, जब भी आपको H mu दिखता है in presence of sunlight, आपको याद रखना है ये specifically saturated hydrocarbon के लिए है, ठीक है? So it can go anywhere other than the saturated hydrocarbon. Now there is one question here. When I prepare RI, generally you will see with KI we use H2SO4. We use H2SO4. So the question is, for preparing I, why we don't use H2SO4? Because H2SO4 is an oxidizing agent, and when I use H2SO4, I get HI. And this HI, which will be formed after I add H2SO4, will be oxidized by H2SO4, because H2SO4 is a good oxidizing agent to iodine. हमें आर आई नहीं मिल पाएगा. द एच आई विच इज फॉर्म्ड इन दिस रिएक्शन विल गेट कन्वर्टेड टू आई टू. नाउ हियर अगेन वी विल सी दिस, दिस इज HBr विद H2O2. तो जब हमें सिर्फ HBr दिखे तो हमें मालूम करना है वो मार्कोनिकॉफ्स रूल है. जब HBr विद H2O2 वी नो इट इज एंटी मार्कोनिकॉफ्स rule. What is anti-Markovnikov's rule? It says that the negative part of the addendum goes to the carbon atom containing more. Markovnikov's rule goes to the one containing less. Anti-Markovnikov's rule is just the opposite of Markovnikov's rule. वो across the double bond में जिस carbon के पास ज़्यादा hydrogen रहेगा, it will go and add to that. So this is just a revision of the questions or which is related to the preparation of alkyl halide. Okay, I hope I am clear with that. Okay, we shall quickly revise with the physical properties of haloalkanes. So higher boiling point, they have got a higher boiling point of chlorides and bromide than those of the hydrocarbon of comparable molecular mass. That means if I take this and I take this, so this is a hydrocarbon and this is a alkyl halide, right? The corresponding alkyl halide. So the boiling point of this will be more than CH4. So the reason being this, I have written it here because it has got a more polarity. Obviously, this is plus and minus because there's a difference in an electronegativity, and more intermolecular force of attraction because they have more of dipole-dipole. They have more dipole-dipole and van der Waals force of attraction. So that is the reason why a alkyl halide has got a more boiling point than the corresponding hydrocarbon. Then we see the isomeric halides. Isomeric halide means if I have primary, secondary and tertiary halide, the tertiary halide will have a lowest boiling point, as the tertiary, say suppose I take a tertiary, okay fine, I'll just show you. If I take a tertiary halide, it takes a spherical shape, and we know that the spherical shape has a least surface area. So in an isomeric, if I take primary, secondary and tertiary will have lowest boiling point. These are the certain points which you have to remember. Similarly, if I take a para and an ortho isomer, so if I take a para, okay, so if I take a para and a, say for example, I take this, and say for example, I take this, so in that case, the para will be isomer, will have a more melting point due to symmetry. Okay, so this, yes, you have to remember, these are the few things which you have to remember, right? It is because it has a symmetry and it fits in crystal lattice better. It fits in crystal lattice better. So if I have, say I take this out and I say this para, okay, so if I take this para, and I take this out and I say ortho and ortho, so you will see the ortho will have a lesser boiling point and the para will have a higher melting point. Now we will talk about solubility in water. Now the solubility should have been more because this is polar. I just said it is a polar compound. So the solubility should have been more in water. But it is sparingly soluble, lesser in water, as more energy is required to break the hydrogen bond in water and also to overcome attraction between haloalkane molecules. Means if I have a haloalkane molecule, so the haloalkane molecule, when I add it to water, they have to break from themselves and also break the water. Now water contains a hydrogen bond, so to break the bond between themselves and to mix with water, they also have to break the bond with H2O. So this process takes lot of energy. More energy is required to break the hydrogen bond because they have to dissolve in it, and also to overcome the attraction between haloalkane molecules. So that's why the solubility is lesser in water. Then if I compare, just one small question, if I can compare bromomethane, bromoform, that is like chloroform CHCH3, bromoform will be CHBr3, chloromethane CH3Cl, dibromomethane CH2Br2. Now if I have to compare the boiling point of all of them, since this has got 3, okay, this is CHBr3, so since it has got a 3 bromine, so this will be having a highest boiling point. Now if I see this chloropropane, chlorobutane and isopropyl chloride. Now we all know isopropyl, that is a secondary one, will have the least. So first will be this highest, then it will be this, and followed by isopropyl chloride. Okay, so that's how we these questions can come with respect to physical properties. I hope I'm clear with the physical properties.